the previous video, we learned that setpoint PD control can eliminate steady state error for a torque-controlled joint in the absence of gravity. If we add gravity, though, the aerodynamics are no longer homogeneous. As a result, even if the aerodynamics are stable, at steady state when theta double dot and theta dot are zero, there will be a non-zero steady state error, mgr cosine theta over kp. For example, imagine the initial resting state of the joint is at minus pi over 2. The desired set point is theta d equals 0. The error response looks like this. The joint stops short of the desired angle. If we plot the torque due to the proportional term and the torque due to the derivative term goes to 0 in steady state, while the proportional term provides the torque that holds the arm at its position in gravity. The point is that there must be error for the controller to provide torque in steady state, and therefore the steady state error cannot be zero. One solution, as we've seen before, is to add an integral term to the controller, giving us set point PID control. To perform a linear analysis, we have to address the nonlinear term that depends on the cosine of the angle. I'll replace this term by a constant, tau disturbance. Replacing by a constant is justified in the upcoming analysis, since I'll be considering the steady state behavior of the controlled robot when this nonlinear term approaches a constant. Equating the dynamics and the control torque, we get the aerodynamics. To get a differential equation, we can differentiate both sides. The result is a homogeneous third-order differential equation with this characteristic equation. By adding an integral term to the controller, we added a state to the dynamics, increasing the order of the differential equation from second order to third order. For stability, the roots must all have a negative real component. As for the PD controller, KD must be greater than minus B, and KP must be greater than 0. The gain KI must also be greater than 0, but unlike KP and KD, KI also has an upper bound for stability. Before, for our second-order differential equation, the only dangers in choosing large gains were due to practical considerations like actuator limits, unmodeled dynamics, and finite servo frequencies. Now, with a third-order PID-controlled system, even our ideal linear model shows that choosing KI too large could result in instability. Let's see this graphically by plotting the roots in the complex plane. First, let's choose KI equal to 0 and choose the gains KP and KD to give critical damping, two co-located roots on the real axis. We'll keep KP and KD constant. Next, let's add a small positive KI. This creates a third root close to the origin. As we increase the gain KI, the two co-located roots move away from each other on the real axis, and the root at the origin moves left. When we've increased KI sufficiently, the two roots meet on the real axis while the third has moved further left. Since the two co-located roots are much slower than the root far to the left, the transient error response of this third-order system is similar to that for a critically damped second-order system. The response is slower than for the original critically damped PD controller, though, because the co-located roots are now further to the right. If we continue to increase KI, the two co-located roots break away from the real axis and move into the right half plane when KI reaches its upper bound for stability. The aerodynamics would be unstable for the roots shown. We've drawn the root locus for KI increasing from 0, and it demonstrates the key features of adding integral control. The integral term can improve steady state response, but it can worsen the transient response. In particular, adding an integral term could cause overshoot and oscillation, and in the worst case, instability. Since stability is paramount in control, often robot controllers avoid the use of an integral term, prioritizing stability over steady state error reduction. Or, if a non-zero gain KI is used, it is chosen to be small. In addition, the magnitude of the integrated error may be capped at a maximum value. Let's design our PID controller to place the roots as shown here, which will yield an underdamped error response. Returning to our example set point control problem, we recall that our original PD controller results in steady state error. Adding a positive gain KI, we see that the PID controller drives the steady state error to zero. The overshoot shows that the response is somewhat underdamped. Examining the torques due to the proportional, integral, and derivative terms, we see that the proportional and derivative terms both go to zero, while the integral term reaches a non-zero steady state. That is the torque that allows the joint to resist gravity even when the error is zero. In the next video, we'll combine PID feedback control with a dynamic model of the arm to derive our gold standard motion controller, the computed torque controller.